but only the tip of a varied attack. This team is dangerous from anywhere on the field at any time. The Buckeyes, too, are explosive. Their leader is Jim Karsatos. He likes the quick kill and Chris Carter. On the ground, these Bucks can also deliver a knockout punch. Team defense. That's the Wolverine motto. No man is bigger than the team. Know your assignment. Swarm to the ball. Together, this group can be an awesome force. Ohio State's defensive warrior is Chris Spielman. Solitary in purpose, yet united in a simple goal. Give no quarter for 60 minutes. Proudly, Spielman stands as the symbol of the Buckeye battle cry. Two champions, one true test. One game, one victor. The setting for our one game test, Ohio Stadium, Columbus, Ohio. There will be nearly 90,000 folks on hand this afternoon. And our weather conditions today are absolutely glorious for this confrontation. The Big Ten Championship. Michigan and Ohio State, and they've decided the title 17 times since 44. And in those 17 games, the Buckeyes have won 8, lost 7 to Michigan, and 2 games have wound up in ties. Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. I am Brent Musburger. There is a bowl reward for both of these fine schools here today. The winner will go to the Granddaddy, the Rose Bowl on New Year's Day, where they will play Arizona State. The winner of the Pac-10 and a team you will see later here this afternoon on CBS. But the loser will not be left out in the cold, for they will travel down to Dallas. They will play in the Cotton Bowl against the Southwest Conference champion. There is so much tradition surrounding this game and an atmosphere in the air of a carnival in the Midwest. Pat O'Brien is down on the sideline with us. Pat?
Brent, you know, you and I were talking on the way to work this morning. It's a shame we can't show all of you out there all the tradition that surrounds the big game. This morning, the tailgaters were out before the fog even lifted here in Columbus, Ohio. The colors and the tradition. Yesterday, right here in Ohio Stadium, they had a traditional ceremony called Senior Tackle, where all the departing seniors come back for one final tackle. Even John Woolridge. Brent, this guy was on crutches, and he took the tackle, and the OSU teammates and fans, they loved it. And then we all heard from a very familiar voice.
So I don't want you standing out here very long. I want you to stay warm and stay warm tomorrow. Keep your gloves on until you go in the ball game and then play the greatest game for the greatest coach you've ever had.
He was talking about Earl Bruce. Mark that day, a modest Woody Hayes. But Woody is here today, and so is all the tradition surrounding the big game. Let's go back upstairs.
All right, Pat, this is the day that the bowl picture comes into focus.
Hey, Annie Matthews, what's on your plate today?
Really busy. 10 media.
From right to left on your television screen, and the forecast, sunny skies here this afternoon. Tickets were selling upwards of $200 and $300 a piece this morning, if you could find one. And the last time these two great schools played, when a Rose Bowl berth went to the winner, and Michigan won it in 1980, 9-3. Ohio State will have first possession, and Pat Moons will put the ball on the tee for Bo Schembechler. The deep men. Everett Ross, number 5, is to the right, and Jamie Holland, number 6, is to the left. And the referee, Tom Quinn, wearing the white hat, will signal, and Moons will come up and begin this confrontation. He's loose. 45. Down to the Wolverine. 45-yard line.
An injury on the field, but it was a beautiful return. Cracked the seam. And what great start. 47-yard return. Here it is from the end zone. You see beautiful blocking. Four and four, and a nice seam open up. Excellent and good running here. Jamie Holland's got tremendous speed. And finally he's brought down, but not after they've gotten into great field position on the opening kickoff.
The injured player was Ken Mouton, number 38, being helped to the Michigan sideline. He came down on the special team coverage and was injured as he attempted to get through that blocking wedge. The lineups. The big man for the Buckeyes, Chris Carter out of Middletown, Ohio. Nate Harris is a good improving flanker. Ed Taggart is the tight end. Vince Workman hasn't been fumbling the last 6 weeks. George Cooper, a bull of a fullback. And the quarterback from Fullerton, California is Jim Carsados. Ohio State, first down at the Michigan 45-yard line. They'll throw on first down. Incomplete, intended for Carter, out of bounds. Dieter Heron, number 35, was the linebacker who dropped back, and Eric Campbell, 5, was the corner. The blockers for Carsados. The left side, Stasniak, Uhlenhake, they are superb. The center is an All-American, Bob Maggs. The right side is young and getting better, Sakharov and Schaefer. Second and 10 for the Buckeyes. Complete to Workman. He slips a tackle, and he's through to the 38-yard line before Ivan Hicks brings him down for the Wolverines.
Pulling all the guns out right off the top. Carsados opens up with a pass to Carter. He overthrew him, and on this one, they come out with trips with motion off to the right side here. Workman does an excellent job of running the ball. Carsados looked off Workman very nicely. There's a missed tackle there by Eric Campbell, number 5, and finally brought down by Ivan Hicks, number 17.
Bo Schembechler's defense faces a third and 2. Workman, first down, Buckeyes, to the 30-yard line. Andre McIntyre wraps him up.
There's no question about the hole being there that time. Left side of the line did an excellent job. Uhlenhake and Stasniak from the end zone. You'll see the thing open up over to the right side. Look at that blocking. Stasniak does a great job, number 79. And there's the hole for Vince Workman.
The Buckeyes with 3 wide receivers. Carter, Ross, and Harris. Complete to Carter inside the 20-yard line. Another Buckeye first down.
They lined up Carter on the inside in the slot to the right. We'll take a look here in the isolation. He's on the inside right here. Comes right down the field, and watch him turn inside of the safety man right there. And Carsados puts it right there on the money. Great opening drive by the Buckeyes.
With that 12-yard gain, Chris Carter becomes the 9th receiver in Big Ten history to go over 1,000 yards in a single season. He comes out to Carsados right. The ball is at the 18 for this first down. Workman could not get past Ivan Hicks along with Andre McIntyre. Let's meet this defense, Coach.
It's been a good study when Mark Messner is the left tackle, the leading sack man on the team. Number 60 there. Billy Harris, a good pass rusher, the nose man, 270. And Dave Folkersma took over at the right tackle spot. Dieter Heron, the best pass rusher on the team. And Andy Moeller, the great linebacker. Andre McIntyre has come on strong. John Willingham, the other outside backer.
Second and 9 for the Bucks. Complete to Carter. driving toward that first down marker, taking on Garland Rivers, number 13.
I think that the Michigan team is playing very soft. You right, see right here, here's Carter. He just comes and breaks to the outside. Watch the cushion that he has. Carsados takes immediate advantage of it. The team is, Michigan's rotated to the opposite side away from Carter, and Carsados took that immediately.
They are measuring on the far side. Jim Beckler's defense must suck it up on this short yardage situation. Garland Rivers keys that secondary, coach.
He's a fine one. They've had a lot of injuries. Ivan Hicks, strong safety, good support man. Tony Gant has had injuries. Finally has come back into the lineup. And Eric Campbell, good all-around football player, playing the wide halfback.
It's been a wide open Ohio State team so far.
Certainly it's not a 3 yard and a cloud of dust, is it? I mean, they come right out, throw the ball, all kinds of formations. You got one-on-one on Carter out here.
Workman, first down, 5 yard line of Michigan. Dieter Heron brings him down.
Well, they put John Hutchins in at the flank back. He's a tight end, 6'3", 234. And you'll see him go in motion. That's a tight end in motion. You get an additional blocker. Actually, Dieter Heron fights him off right there and makes the play with help from Garland Rivers. Boy, he had a great day last week against Wisconsin.
So after a brilliant return of the opening kickoff, the Buckeyes march down, and this is first and goal. Workman, stop, no gain. Andy Moeller, 49, the ringleader of that Wolverine defense, smacks him at the line of scrimmage.
Well, he's the number one tackler on this football team with 103 involvements. I'm talking about Andy Moeller. His dad is a defensive coordinator, Gary Moeller. Done a great job with the Wolverines. It gets tough down in here. When you don't have as much field to defend, you can crowd across the line of scrimmage. You see him giving a signal. That was Gary Moeller, the defensive coordinator, getting a signal in defensively.
Here is Woody Hayes, familiar full house. Matlock, the additional running back, blocking for Workman. The Wolverines were ready. It was power against power, and Moeller, young Moeller, did the job.
Yes. Well, we talk about the full house backfield, or the what Woody Hayes called the robust. All backs are back here in the line. The old button shoe T formation, or the robust as Woody called it, and the full house as you call it. They run the power off tackle, but not successfully this time.
Chris Carter returns. He has caught 9 touchdown passes.
You've got to believe that they're going to go one-on-one again. They got one-on-one on Carter.
Third and goal.
There it is.
Carter's looking for him. Touchdown, Buckeyes.
You just knew that that's what they're going to do.
To attempt the extra point. Buckeyes strike first.
You see right here, single coverage. We can't see it quite from this picture, but we will. It's one-on-one, Eric Campbell trying to cover Chris Carter. No chance. He can jump 34, 35 inches straight up. Carter is a great receiver.
Only a junior. This touchdown catch, number 10. He's 6'3", 194. His brother was a great NBA basketball player, and now his young brother Chris wants to go to the NFL as a wide receiver. It's Ohio State 7, Michigan nothing. We'll be right back. Touchdown call from the sideline, and it was his number.
Folks, how'd you like to be out here all by yourself? That's Eric Campbell, number 5 on Chris Carter. And you can tell upstairs Karsanis was going to take advantage. There he beats him right now, and he jumps up and takes the ball away. Karsanis threw it away from Campbell. Great play.
The Wolverines will touch the ball for the first time, trailing 7-0. Pat O'Marlow to kick it off for the Buckeyes. That scoring drive, 10 plays, had 5 running plays and 5 passing plays.
And most of the yardage came, Brent, passing, 32 of that 45.
The deep men for the Wolverines, Eric Campbell is 5, and Jamie Morris to the right is 23. A short kickoff. It's Morris. A hole in the middle. Morris, 35, out to the 40-yard line, and the Buckeyes have difficulty covering that kick. Mike Showalter makes the tackle. How about the offense for Michigan, Coach?
Paul Jokic has had a pulled hamstring. He's 6'8", as you see, a tremendous target. Brett McMurtry, tremendous speed, and just a freshman at the flanker back spot. Jeff Brown, a tight end, has great feet, good hands. Jamie Morris, really an outstanding football player. Gerald White, strong blocker and outstanding receiver. And, of course, Jimmy Harbaugh, he's the key.
You mentioned Jokic. Because of that injury, he is not playing. The wishbone. That was Gerald White, hit by David Brown. White is a fullback when they attack from the eye, but he comes one of the halfbacks out of the wishbone.
Right at the fullback spot, of course, is the fullback, and number 22 is White at the right half spot. Two big fullbacks in there, and Bo is keeping his word. He's going to try to establish a running game, and that's the beginning of it.
Second and 3 for the Wolverines. Ball is at their 47. White slips a tackle short of the first down, hit by Michael Key, number 30, who came across from his linebacking spot.
This is a fine offensive line. You see the size of a Mike Hussar at left tackle. He's at the split side. Michael Dames at the left guard. Very strong, hard nose. John Vitale has been very important to them at that center. Mark Hammerstein, very steady performer at the right guard. And here's the guy you want to watch, John Elliott, number 72, at the tackle.
Michigan so effective on third down this year. 53% they have been able to convert to first down.
He got it. See Bo calling the plays from the sideline. Harbaugh went right to the sideline to get the information. Look at this, is excellent third down conversions for Michigan at 53.5%. That's remarkable.
So Perriman picks up another one for the Wolverines. The first down just inside of midfield.
Audible.
Harbaugh throws to White, out of bounds at the 41-yard line. Sonny Gordon, the Rover, number 7 there defensively.
Bo told me when Jokic had a pulled groin, he wasn't sure whether he was going to be able to play, that he would use White as a receiver quite a bit. You see him lined up right here in this slot. He breaks right out as the defender is driven off. And, of course, with a fake on the inside by Harbaugh, the tailback action or the sprint draw, White breaks right in front of the corner, right there. Harbaugh puts it right on the money, and that's why he's a 66% completion man.
Second and 1. This is not a typical Michigan-Ohio State game. They run White straight ahead for the first down. He stepped over behind the left side of the line, and Chris Spielman, number 36, makes the stop for the Buckeyes. the junior linebacker from Massillon, Ohio, keeping an eye on Harbaugh and the ball, moving quickly to the point of attack and taking White down. But the play accomplished its mission. First down for Michigan. The ball is at the Ohio State 37-yard line.
Michigan's using a lot of bone, a lot of wishbone formation. Unbalanced line to the right.
Morris wrapped up by Spielman.
Spielman really is an outstanding football player. Number one tackler on the team. All-American, 165 involvements so far this year. His tackle for loss is 8 times for 24 yards. And he's not a little guy. 6'2", 232, and runs a 4.640.
Second and 7 for the Wolverines. Complete to White. First down, Michigan. Spielman chasing the receiver and hauling him down. It's an 11-yard gain. Let's check in on another rivalry. Holy Cross. Jim Nance, how are they doing against Boston College?
All right, Brent, the unbelievable season for Holy Cross and Gordy Lockbaum continues. They're 10-0 on the year, taking on BC, a team that's won 6 straight. But there he is, Gordy Lockbaum, taking it into the end zone, and the Crusaders are cruising early in the first quarter. Let's go back to Brent and Nara, 14-6.
All right, Jim, and our situation here with 8 minutes to go and the clock moving in the first quarter. The Buckeyes lead Michigan 7-0, but the Wolverines are on the move, and they are inside the 25.
They're audible again.
This is White. Step back inside. He collided with Dames, one of his offensive linemen, and Derek Eisenman tripped him up.
Well, White's caught 2 passes thus far, and one wouldn't realize it. As a fullback, he's the leading receiver on this football team. This is quite an opening drive, Brent, for both teams. I mean, Ohio State drove that ball down, scored in 10 plays. Here's Michigan driving back the other way. Whale of a football game.
Second and 9 for Harbaugh. Complete. He hit his tight end, Jeff Brown, and the sophomore was tackled by Greg Rogan.
There you are, your tight end number 80 is Jeff Brown. Real upstays right here, and he'll cross underneath here while the others are driving off in the fake. Watch Harbaugh hit him as he crosses underneath here. He's 6'4", 224 pounds, a sophomore, releases off the line, goes between Spielman and Keys. They could have gotten a piece of him right there, and that pressures, of course, number 29, Greg Rogan.
He got enough yardage for the first down. Wolverines first down at the Ohio State 14. They trail by 7. Here's Morris up the middle. Gets 4 yards to the 10-yard line, and Spielman is there to take him on along with 95, Darrell Lee. The Spielman-led defense of the Buckeyes. But there was a hole there, and Morris slammed down to the 10-yard line. It's 2nd and 6 for the Wolverines.
Spending an awful lot of time at the line of scrimmage.
On the option. Nowhere. Great defense by Ohio State. They're over. Sonny Gordon coming across with the tackle. But they took the quarterback away from the play, and that keyed it defensively.
That's exactly right, Brent. Harbaugh was trying to run the option right down the line, but he is forced to pitch the ball before he wants to. Look at there, Derek Eisenman, number 10, forces the pitch, and there's Sonny Gordon, number 7, coming up to make the play. Excellent job. And here we look at it from ground level from the defensive side. That's 30, that's Key, coming up to support. There's the deal off, and there's Sonny Gordon, and then help from Key, number 30.
This is 3rd and 11. Higgins and McMurtry are the wide receivers for the Wolverines. Harbaugh. Hit as he releases. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down. There is a penalty flag on the field. A penalty flag was thrown in the far end zone.
Brent, I was just about to say how well this game is being played. There has not been one penalty called, and 10 minutes have gone by in the first quarter, which is, let's see what it is.
Delay a game here.
You said that they were taking a long time at the line of scrimmage, and Bo will not be happy about that.
Well, of course, Ohio State will turn it down, refuse the penalty. They don't want another third down opportunity in this position on the field. There's Bo. Unless it was a dead ball, let's see whether or not they...
If they ruled it was a dead ball,
it was.
He'll get another. Have another opportunity here on third down. That's what Bo was straightening out with the officials. Otherwise, he would have sent his field goal unit into the game.
That's exactly right, Brett. He'll get another third down opportunity, but he's got a long way to go.
We see Jokic for the first time in this game. He will be slotted to Harbaugh's right.
Look for the alley-oop pass, maybe in the end zone to Jokic.
A screen. Drops it off to White. To the 15-yard line. David Brown wraps him up. It's field goal time for the Wolverines.
Good defensive response on that screen by the entire Buckeye team. They smelled it out, got over there and defended. Here we see it. Harbaugh comes back, draws in the defenders, then dumps the ball off to White, number 22. The wall is forming. Number 76 is Dames, who makes a nice block. But boy, what a good job of supporting.
The flashing cards that Mike Gillette will have to contend with. It's a 32-yarder on its way, and Michigan is on the scoreboard. We're in the first quarter. It's Ohio State 7, Michigan 3. We'll be right back. Ohio State leading 7-3. We all know what a Wolverine is, but Pat O'Brien, what in the world is a Buckeye?
Brent, I'm glad you asked. A Buckeye's from the nut family here, and the animal experts tell us this week that when a Wolverine eats a Buckeye, the Wolverine dies. But Brent, I gotta think that if anybody eats a Buckeye, they die, don't you think? I think that's part of the hype of the big game. Let's go back upstairs.
All right, Pat. Moons to kick it off for Michigan. Now, it was a great return by Jamie Holland that set up the Buckeyes' opening scoring drive. He's number 6. He's to the left side. He'll get opportunity number 2. He fumbles at the goal line. And he downs it for the touchback. And did you see Everett Ross go right to him and say, don't come out? It's a touchback when you fumble it into the end zone. Well schooled back there on that return. We've seen a lot of young men mess that up.
Then I think they're going to have to double up on Carter. Let's see what kind of adjustments Gary Moeller made, the defensive coordinator. He's too dangerous out there alone.
Workman, 2 yards, and Andy Moeller, 49, the leading tackler for the Wolverines, brings him down. This will be 2nd and 8.
Moeller did a nice job of stepping in there to fill the hole. It looked like there was a hole pretty well blocked, but Moeller, coming from his strong linebacker position on the inside, did an excellent job.
Chris Carter is off to Carsato's right. Carsato's to throw, and he has Everett Ross. Ross, 3 at midfield, spins to the 45 before Rivers
beautiful
is able to bring it down.
What a great route, Brent. They ran a perfect route against that defense. And then, of course, did an outstanding job of running once he got the football. You'll see him come right into the seam, get in behind a strong safety. You can't quite see it right here, but watch Carsatis drop the ball over the safety. And, of course, watch Ross run this ball, spinning and turning, until finally Garland Rivers, 13, gets him down.
and linebacker Andre McIntyre, who missed Ross from behind, is the injured Wolverine player down at the 45-yard line. That's the player from Chicago who is down. Let's go back to Everett Ross for a moment. He broke all of the great Archie Griffin's high school rushing records. But because he suffered a neck injury, he was unable to continue as a running back. And now he is coming on as one of the more dangerous wide receivers here at Ohio State. We've got a timeout, and we'll be right back. 3 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the first quarter. Ohio State's second possession of the game, and the Buckeyes are on the drive again. Jim Carsados, their quarterback, missed his first pass, and he has hit his last five for 64 yards, including that touchdown to Carter. He audibles at the line of scrimmage. On the pitch, it's Workman. He's free at the 35. Vince Workman will go for a touchdown. They won't catch him. It's good. The Buckeyes have touched the ball twice, and they have two touchdowns.
And what a big play that was. And the cutback, you see Taggart, number 80, makes a great block. It's the option play. Carsados deals the ball off beautifully. Now, if you watch number 15, David Arnold, the right cornerback, will slip and fall right there. And that's the reason there's no contain on Workman, and he goes all the way.
So we'll be right back to Ohio Stadium with the Buckeyes leading 14-3.
Ohio State looks...
Aaron, what's the key block by a lineman?
Oh, this was beautifully blocked. Watch Jay Schaefer come right here and block Moeller. Just buries him. Watch this. He releases off the line. Moeller fills, and look at Schaefer just bury him right there. Now, another great block, number 80, right here on Taggart on Dieter Herron. Watch him sustain this block all the way across as Workman cuts behind him right there. Beautiful job. And then at the top of the picture, you will see Arnold right there, slips and falls, and he can't contain on Workman. Right there, and it's all over with us. Workman's got tremendous speed. Garland Rivers can't catch him. Touchdown for the Buckeyes.
The men who blew open that hole. Schaefer, and then Taggart on the other side, and Vince Workman, the sophomore, goes 46 yards. And it was the reception of 32 yards to Everett that set up the 46-yard touchdown run. And the Buckeyes have stunned Michigan with the big play here in the first quarter. Now Amaro to kick it off to Campbell and Morris. It's a short kickoff. Fielded at the 13. And Gerald White is pounded down at the 25. Jim Harbaugh's turn. And Pittsburgh. Oh, with that throw, the bowl picture up in the air. And it would be one of the greatest upsets in the history of that school. Gerald McMurtry, the freshman wide receiver, comes to Harbaugh's left. Harbaugh calls another play at the line of scrimmage. They run the draw with Morris. Pound at the 31. Greg Rogan pounded him. This is a second
and four. Morse, he's wrapped up.
And that was Michael Key, number 30, who broke across along with Spielman.
And it is third and seven for the Wolverines.
Harbaugh deep to McMurtry. He's got it. Harbaugh, receivers are covered. He waits, goes to McMurtry. Oh, he dropped it at the goal line. Craig McMurtry with a touchdown in hand couldn't hold on for the Wolverines.
Oh, that's great scrambling by Harbaugh and a beautiful throw. They look at it from the end zone. He faked Morris clear on the little misdirection. He gets outside. He's looking for his fullback. Now he comes back to the inside. He sees McMurtry breaking right to left, wide open, right in the hands. Oh, boy, what a tough break. Look at him hide his head. He knows he's blown an opportunity for a score.
You don't need to say he dropped the ball. All of you watching can see that. This is second and 10. Harbaugh with an inside pitch, fumble. Loose ball at the 43. Let's see how the officials rule on the play.
Just an incomplete pass. He dealt the ball off. He didn't have possession of the ball, Brent. Threw it forward. Sometimes it looks like a fumble because of the way it's dealt, but it's an incomplete pass. The Buckeyes are getting a lot of penetration defensively and disrupting the offense. Here it is again from ground level. Harbaugh comes back, looks upfield. Now watch him just kind of shovel pass, but you see 95 Lee is unblocked and responds very well. He never had possession of the ball.
This is third and 10. Three wide receivers, Higgins, Jokic, McMurtry. Intercepted. That is Brown. Jamie Morris and Perelman tackle him, and there's a penalty marker thrown near the 40-yard line. The ball was overthrown a touch, but Jokic had his hands on it.
I thought he should have caught the ball. It looked like it went right through his hands, Brent. Let's see what the call is.
5-yard face mask.
Face mask.
We already got the clip.
Let's take a look as Jokic breaks from your right to your left. It looked to me as if the ball just went right through his hands, right? Well, it was thrown slightly behind him. It would have been a tough catch. He has a pulled groin and probably could not respond to it as well as he normally would have if he'd been healthy. And here it is in the middle here. There it is. You see it's slightly behind him. And, of course, there it is with David Brown picking it up. He has lightning speed, and there was a 5-yard face mask. Look at the official get knocked down.
Brown had a tough job in that secondary. He replaced Terry White, who was tossed off this Buckeye team and has subsequently transferred to West Virginia. Brown was burned early on in this season. But now he has been maturing, and that's a difficult position for a freshman back in center field on defense. This will be first and 10. The ball is at the Buckeye 42. They have scored each of the two times they've handled the ball. Workman, he's loose again. Run down inside the 30-yard line by Eric Campbell.
Great job by the right guard and right tackle pulling to lead that little misdirection play. Ohio State has run that play successfully. They ran it last week against Michigan. Watch the guard, the right guard or left guard, left tackle pull and lead through. Great block. Look at that hole open up for Workman, and boy, he knows what to do with that ball after he gets into that secondary. Garland Rivers tries to make the play. He runs right through his tackle, and finally Eric Campbell brings him down.
a 29-yard gain following that 46-yard touchdown run. Workman, 8 carries, 90 yards. The first down is inside the 30-yard line, and the fullback, Cooper, steps up to the 26.
I love working here. It's exciting.
See the audible being called by Karsatis.
Moeller bluffed a blitz. There's a penalty marker down. Chris Carter was out of bounds. No catch on the far side. Penalty marker at the line of scrimmage. Tom Quinn will have the details.
Holding on the offense.
That's Ed Hassel, the umpire, made that call for Quinn's crew.
Only the second penalty thus far in this game. One of the things historically in this game, there are very few penalties. Bo Schembechler coaches against penalties. Earl Bruce does. And you know where they learned it from? Woody Hayes, who recognized the importance of avoidance of penalties.
You'll hear from Woody at halftime. Jim traveled out to Columbus to interview the Ohio State legend who was in attendance, watching down below. And Von Schembechler orders a little more discipline on his sideline. The ball is at the 26-yard line of Ohio State. We've got 13:43 to go in the first half. This will be a second and 19 for the Buckeyes. They lead Michigan 14-3. Three wide receivers. Jamie Holland joins Carter and Harris. Carsato slips again. He still throws to Carter, and he overthrew him out of the back of the end zone. That was not Carter. Let me correct that. That was Jamie Holland, number 6.
Brent, I thought that Carsato's touched the ball to the ground. Apparently, the officials missed it as he was regaining his balance on the second attempt. He stumbles coming out right here. Gathers himself. He tripped over the Mags' feet, number 71. Now as he comes out and tries to run, I looked like the ball touched, but maybe it was close enough. Let's take another look at it. Let's see if it touches here. It looked from up here that he might have. Well, it didn't right there. I guess it didn't. Quinn, the referee, picked it up. Very good.
Ohio State is perfect on third down conversions. This will be their biggest challenge yet. It's third and 19. Incomplete. Everett Ross was to have been the intended receiver. Carter, cutting toward the sideline, was underneath, and Ross was confused about the pattern.
But the thing that strikes me up here is that Michigan has had absolutely no one rushing the passer. They just can't seem to get the Karsatis. And they're going to have to put on a better rush if they expect to stop him, because he is a dangerous, dangerous man.
Matt France to attempt a 43-yard field goal.
You don't think so.
And it'll stay at 14-3. Michigan's ball at 13:24. So we'll take a break, and we'll be right back to Ohio Stadium in a moment.
Hi.
Stadium in Columbus, Ohio, with the Rose Bowl and the Cotton Bowl on the line, along with the Big Ten Championship. It's Michigan and Ohio State. The Buckeyes score the first two times they touch the ball here this afternoon. The Wolverines settle for a field goal and drop what would have been a scoring pass. It's 14-3, and the Buckeye offense has dominated this game behind their ever-improving offensive line. For the afternoon, Ohio State, with those 14 points, have recorded 185 yards to Michigan's 87. Michigan's turn it back. First down, the 20-yard line. Jamie Morris, no daylight.
I'll tell you, the Ohio State defense is playing as well as the Ohio State offense. They're commanding the line of scrimmage. They neutralized the Michigan Wolverine offensive line that time beautifully. And, of course, we've seen what the offense has done already. Michigan needs to get something going, and it looks like the only way right now is to throw the football.
Their running game, I mean Michigan's, has been stuffed. 13 carries for 26 yards. That's not the kind of resistance Schembechler expected here today. Second and 11.
Harbaugh to throw. He's got McMurtry down the sideline and out of bounds at the 44-yard line. Sonny Gordon chasing him. That was a great play.
Brent, that was a great throw by Harbaugh again. McMurtry runs up the field and down the sideline. Sonny Gordon, number 7, tries to stay with him. You see McMurtry breaking the lower part of your screen there, and then he turns up. Sonny Gordon's trying to turn to run with him. Look at the ball Harbaugh puts right in there. This is what Michigan has to do, I think.
25-yard gain and a first down for the Wolverines. Morris on the cutback. His best run of the afternoon. Close to a first down. He crosses midfield down near the 46-yard line.
Just great running by Jamie Morris. That ball, that was supposed to be a pitch sweep. The response by the defense, as you see, will go out to the outside here, and he has to run it clear back against the grain. You see sustained blocks. Number 72, John Elliott, did a great job. And that time it was excellent running. It looks like we might have a penalty here, though. Well, I guess they're measuring there. I was looking at the replay of that.
Measurement. So close to a first down on that run by Jamie Morris, who is one of the leading ball carriers in the Big Ten Conference this year. Harbaugh signaling that it's a first down. And the winner of this game will meet Arizona State in the Rose Bowl, and you'll get a chance to check in on the Sun Devils. Jeff Van Raphorst, their talented quarterback. And that is a good rivalry in the Pac-10. Arizona State and Arizona coming your way next here on CBS this afternoon. Thomas Wilcher checks into the backfield for Michigan. He is the tailback.
You see, Harbaugh has to cup his hands to get that audible to him.
Wilcher pounds to the 42-yard line, picking up 3 yards. Darryl Lee and Chris Spielman bring him down for Earl Bruce's Buckeyes.
Seems to me that the Wolverines cannot get the cutoff block on the backside tackle. That time it was Darryl Lee, and that's happened on more than one occasion. It seems like the timing is off on the back getting up into the hole, and the Buckeyes are closing down on the intended block hole.
Jamie Morris returns for Schembechler. Plenty of time in the first half. 8-14. Harbaugh wide open is Higgins at the 25, and he's to the 22-yard line with Gordon bringing him down.
Beautiful route. This is exactly what they needed to do, as I said earlier. At the top of the screen, you'll see Higgins here, and he'll drive off and break across the middle, and Harbaugh will put it right there after he fakes the run action. He'll fake the sprint draw right there. Now you see the tight end crossing underneath, and the cornerback lets Higgins go, and look how wide open he is. The deep people are really giving him a lot of cushion.
Two tight ends, Walker and Brown, and they run Perriman to the 18-yard line with Spielman making the stop for the Bucks. That's Bob Perriman, the senior from Buzzards Bay, Massachusetts, and Spielman, the young All-America linebacker for the Buckeyes, taking him on.
Well, this Buckeye defense has just played sensational football. Got off to that shaky start in their opening game against Alabama and then Washington out there. And they've come back with 9 straight wins, and the defense has played superbly during that entire period.
McMurtry goes to the top of your screen. Higgins is at the bottom. Second and 5 for the Wolverines. Harbaugh moving back to the right. He'll step out of bounds, and he's crushed at the 18-yard line. Mike Sullivan and Chris Spielman sandwich the Michigan quarterback.
And Brent, excellent coverage by the defensive secondary. There was no one open. Harbaugh did the right thing to run the football, get it out of bounds, stop the clock, and not throw it away for an interception.
This is 3rd and 5 and a key play here in the first half. Wolverines trailing 14-3.
Big Jokic, now 6'8", is back into the ballgame again. Carried the play in.
They slot him on the left. Three wide receivers. And Harbaugh having difficulty because of the roaring crowd here in Columbus. So he will ask for an official's timeout. Back away, take a deep breath. Bo Schembechler's staff on the sideline will take the opportunity to change the play because the Buckeyes.
Just announce and make the announcement.
And make the announcement that the Buckeyes will be penalized if they continue on with this, and they'll take a timeout away from them.
Ladies and gentlemen, may we have your attention, please. NCAA rules make it mandatory that the offensive team must be able to hear their signals. We request your cooperation and courtesy to the offensive team. Further noise infractions will result in a charge timeout to the defensive team or possibly a yardage penalty.
The crowd is duly informed and not too impressed, I might add, here in Columbus.
Well, let's see if they quiet down or not.
Third and five, and Spielman saying, don't cost us a timeout. Harbaugh and Quinn conferring. Now Quinn walks away. Earl Bruce.
He doesn't want that charge timeout. Blitz.
He throws it up for grabs.
Oh, it is
incomplete. And Higgins went down. There was a collision between the defensive back and the wide receiver. William White, number 37, hopped into Higgins in the end zone.
Look, knocked Higgins down. Couldn't tell. I thought the ball was catchable. Let's take a look at it in the end zone. Higgins is number 31. There he is being knocked down. And the ball is, well, it's not a catchable ball for him. And here it is from the top. You see him get knocked down right there. I'm surprised he didn't throw the flag, but because he may have been able to get to that ball, and it may have been catchable by the time he got in the end zone. I see that as an interference call.
Mike Gillette will attempt a 34-yard field goal. He made one from 32 earlier. A line drive three-pointer by Gillette. Well, he's a baseball player, and that was a line smash to center field, and it's 14-6. And still, Ohio State has not allowed a Big Ten team to score a touchdown in Ohio Stadium this season. What a defense.
Ball into the end zone twice to get the 14 points, but you see now the momentum is shifting in this game as the Michigan in the second quarter has been able to get a lot of yardage. But there's the big statistic right there, 14-6. Ohio State kept the Wolverines.
Defense has kept Ohio State from pulling away. As we draw closer to halftime in this rivalry game, Michigan has the ball, and despite their struggles, a Wolverines touchdown on this drive will get them down only 1 point heading into the locker room. So let's get back out to Columbus and see if Harbaugh can get his team going.
It's 14-6. The Buckeyes lead the Wolverines, 3:46 to go in the first half. McMurtry goes to Harbaugh's left. One wide receiver. Morris. Swatted down at the 20-yard line. David Brown, 27, wrapping up the Michigan tailback, who is the brother of the New York Giants star, Joe Morris.
Brent, on the last drive that Michigan had, they had open receivers over the middle. Higgins caught one down the center that was a big play, and the Buckeyes were zoning off. But Higgins was able to get beyond the linebackers in front of the deep secondary, and they had a couple of big plays. Let's see if they go back to that.
Jokic
replaces McMurtry. It's second and four. Harbaugh. And he's to the 24-yard line, and you can hear the contact. Derek Eisenman and Eric Comerow up to meet him.
The defense came up and met Harbaugh well.
Harbaugh scrambling enough for the first down. Both teams with all their timeouts remaining in the first half. The clock running. Harbaugh with a fresh set of downs. The wind is blowing in his face, and it's a touch brisker than it was. Complete to the tight end Brown, who spins away from one tackler, gets to the 38, and he does not spin away from Mr. Spielman.
Harbaugh put a little zip on that ball. He was throwing the ball off balance. It was almost a sidearm. He spotted Brown a little late, but he got it right there.
It's 13 more yards for Harbaugh.
You see, he fakes a sprint draw. He's looking off to his left. Finally, at the last second, he spots Brown right over here. There it is. Bang. He zips it over to him. Brown sheds one tackler, and then he's finally brought down, but not before he picks up the first down. Draw.
It's the draw with Morris to the 48-yard line, and it's David Brown and Michael Key, number 30, wrapping up Morris.
You get the feeling now that the momentum has shifted in this game. In the early going, it was all Buckeyes. Now you see the Wolverines starting to establish their offense. Jamie Morris is almost tripped up there. The sprint draw on the cutback was very well executed.
But folks who have watched the Buckeye defense all season long know that they give up a lot of yardage in midfield as they are now. But they have been extremely tough in giving up touchdowns. Michigan has been denied. They must settle for two field goals.
As evidenced by the 6 points on the board, both coming as a result of field goals, and denied the Wolverines touchdowns in the drives that they had earlier.
Schembechler upset on the far sideline, the ball being placed by the officiating crew. Apparently, the chains were moved too quickly. Now comes the signal for the first down. After they had moved them, they moved them back. That's what Bo was upset about. So they went back for a full measurement, bringing the chains across the field. It was enough for a first down. The ball is at the 48-yard line for Harbaugh and the Wolverines. Time running here. Harbaugh. Good protection. And he throws to Morris, and he's to the 47-yard line, where Michael Key brings him down, and Harbaugh signals for the timeout. That's the first timeout that Michigan uses here in the first half. We're going to break away, and we'll be back. We've got 1:31 to go, and the Buckeyes lead 14-6. Coach Parsegan, the tale of the numbers here in the two quarters.
Well, they tell the story pretty well. You can see the first quarter was dominated by the Buckeyes, but they got the ball into the end zone twice to get the 14 points. But you see now the momentum is shifting in this game as Michigan in the second quarter has been able to get a lot of yardage. But there's the big statistic right there, 14-6. Ohio State kept the Wolverines out of their end zone and forced them to field goals.
This is a second and five for the Wolverines. Harbaugh with three wide receivers. Movement. The defense jumping completely across the line that time on that staggered count by Jim Harbaugh.
And they'll get a cheap first down here.
So it was the dead ball offside is what Quinn was telling the crowd as his wireless mic needs a fresh battery here at the intermission. We're only a minute 30 away from hearing you again, Mr. Quinn. It's 14-6. Of course, you don't think a referee would ever forget how to turn it on. Does that ever happen?
Now, they're turning them on so often in the NFL that those guys deserve an extra fee. It's gotten ridiculous. This is first and 10, 1:31 to go in the first half.
Two timeouts for the Wolverines.
Harbaugh under pressure, drops it off to Morris. Morris hounds his way to the 30-yard line. He runs as tough as his brother.
Picked up 12 yards, another first down, stops the clock while he moved the chains. And this has been an impressive drive. And also an excellent job of Harbaugh scrambling, the thing that we talked about at the beginning. Look at here, the pressure that he gets. Now he steps right out, hits Jamie Morris, and he picks up 12 before Key brings him down along with Spielman.
There's Morris right up the middle. To the 9-yard line with Greg Rogan hauling him down. And it is suddenly the Jamie Morris show here in Columbus.
What a hole he got. And did he hit it quick? Obviously, the Buckeyes were looking for pass, and he hit that hole and banged into that secondary. Watch it from the end zone here. Linebackers running off. You see 72, John Elliott blocks right there. Spielman, 36, a beautiful job. And away goes Jamie Morris.
Can the Wolverines score inside of a minute? That's the key here. First and goal after the 22-yard run. Harbaugh to throw on first down. Intercepted by Key at the one. And Key is out of bounds at the 4-yard line. A huge play for the Buckeyes.
The toe.
Michigan rivalry. Then Woody Hayes.
Michael Key from Eastmore.
Who's getting the information on the sideline as to who was that young man who intercepted that pass.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. And
there's his student, Bo Schembechler.
And Bo says that the intensity of this rivalry started by Woody Hayes and then carried on by Bo through the years. Well, he's a tough guy.
He told the team yesterday that they would have to play the game of their lives to handle Schembechler and the Wolverines. And here this afternoon in the first half, the Buckeyes have dominated. They have made all the big plays, and Michigan has made the big mistakes, but there's still a half to go. Parsatos referring to run the clock down here with the Wolverines out of timeouts. They are satisfied to go into the locker room ahead 14-6. When they played their first home game after losing those two games at the start of the season, the crowd here in Columbus, Ohio was booing the Buckeyes. There are no boos at this moment. The Buckeyes are 30 minutes away from Pasadena. And we'll hear from Woody Hayes. He was interviewed by Jim Nance. We'll be right back with our halftime activities in a moment. And Amaro will kick it off. Jamie Morris and Eric Campbell set to return for the Wolverines.
Almost guarantee some kind of a return when you get a 5-yard penalty and kick it from the 30. Oh, good kick though.
Inside the 5, Morris is coming back. That's a great kick by Amaro. The Wolverines will have a first down at the 12-yard line, and Sean Bell, the sophomore Roverback, got down on Morris. His brother, Todd Bell, plays with the Chicago Bears.
Pat O'Morrow really put the foot to that, and Jamie Morris had to take it. Going backwards, had no momentum coming forward, and the coverage was excellent, so they have to start at their own 17. Nice job by Pat O'Morrow.
Harbaugh
will have Perriman and Morris as his running backs, McMurtry his wide receiver, and two tight ends, and they pound with Perriman out to the 20-yard line or the 19, depending on where the ball is placed.
See, whether or not Bo wants to establish the running game again, I still say that their strong suit is Harbaugh with his hands in the ball and McMurtry in the secondary. There's Bo. I'm sure that they had to talk about what they want to do in this second half. It'll develop as we possibly get better field position for the Wolverines.
Second and seven. Higgins, the wide receiver to the left. Throws it to the tight end, Brown. First down at the 40-yard line with William White, number 37, tackling him after a 21-yard gain.
A naked bootleg. Everything went away, and the fake was good. You watch here as Harbaugh goes away from all the would-be blockers. Even the guards are pulling to the right to make it look like a sweep to the right. Derek Eisenman doesn't know whether to chase Harbaugh or go after Brown, and now they're in good field position. One of the things, Brent, that the Michigan coaches do at halftime is prepare their team well and make adjustments, and certainly that might have been the beginning of one.
The tight end Brown has caught three balls for 42 yards this afternoon. They run Morris. He spins and picks up two more yards after he was stopped near the line of scrimmage. Eric Comerill, 14, making the stop. And Jamie Morris showing you that same determination that Joe Morris of the Giants gives you on Sunday afternoons.
Well, Gary Blackney, the defensive coordinator of Ohio State, has done a marvelous job with this Buckeye team as the season has progressed. This just isn't the same football team that started the season.
It's second and six for the Wolverines. Here's Morris behind Perriman. Beautiful block. It's a first down for Michigan.
Ohio State brought a hard corner, but he was blocked out by the fullback, and Jamie Morris took that seam. Jamie is a tough little guy. If you watch up at the replay, the top of your screen, you'll see the corner, the short corner, come hard, and watch a fullback take him to the outside. Right there, bang. He hits right into the seam there, and Jamie comes up the sideline, finally brought down by Morris and other Buckeyes.
Greg McMurtry back in. He's at the bottom of your screen. Thomas Wiltshire is now in at halfback. Rolling to the right. In and out of the hands of McMurtry, who has dropped two balls here this afternoon.
Pretty tough one. It looked like me as if Harbaugh threw that down into the ground. He generally throws the ball well on the move. That one looked like a low ball. There it is on the move. They're flooding the strong side with three receivers. Wiltshire 27 there picking up the block for him. There's the ball. You see it actually hits the ground and tries bounces up, but he had no chance of
that. Yeah, no chance. That was incomplete. It did not go in out of his hands until after it hit the carpet. Second and 10. Hits McMurtry, who is out of bounds at the 36-yard line. That is short of a first down, or going to be very close.
That was an excellent throw by Harbaugh. Beautiful throw. Right there, right to sideline. It's a long pass, and he hits McMurtry right there. A nice job. Now let's take a look at John Elliott, number 72. Right there, pick up his block here and keep Harbaugh clean of any pass rush. There's a stunt to the inside. You see the 94 blitzes to the inside, Brown, and of course the wipe off, and look at Elliott just stay right there and pick him up.
While you were showing the replays, they measured it was enough. He had stepped just beyond it for the first down. Harbaugh barking the play out to his wide men. This is Wiltshire. Can't break free, and that was key. The first player to hit him and slow him up, and he would not allow Wiltshire to swing free.
Well, you're right on that point, Brent. That key did a marvelous job. Otherwise, you're going to get some yardage out of that, but he wiped off of his linebacker's post. He has great speed. Was down on the field yesterday and didn't realize how big he is. He's 6'2", 214. He looked to me like he was a lot bigger than that. He was big on that play.
This will be a second and 10. Morris returns for the Wolverines. Two wide receivers are Higgins and McMurtry. Morris steps back to the right. Key helping out on that stop near the 31. Derek Eisenman on the other side.
That's Key. Looks like he might, well, I guess he's all right, hurt his foot.
He made an enormous interception in the closing minute of the first half to snuff out a Michigan scoring drive. The Wolverines have turned it over twice on two interceptions. The Buckeyes have not turned it over yet. This is third and five for Harbaugh.
Big play. Good protection.
Drops it off to the tight end, Brown. And he is hit short of that first down. Chris Spielman with the tackle for the Buckeyes.
They've seen that play a lot where Brown, the tight end, lined up in the regular tight end spot. Then he slow blocks and delays, waits for the linebackers to drift to their areas for coverage. Right here is Brown. You'll see him slow block here and then drift right in here after the linebackers have expanded. You see him wait right in there. He's blocking, blocking. Now the linebackers drop off. Now there he is. There's the seam. Good call, good play. And they caught the Buckeyes in zone, which is the play that's when you can execute that the best.
Harbaugh signaling to the bench that he is that short.
Oh, he is a little short.
Now that was a great play by Spielman to deny him the first down. Pat Thomas has checked in at nose guard. Era Fred Ritter injured for the Buckeyes at the nose. How will that affect them?
It could affect them because now they're young at that position. They're down to their third guy. It could have a big effect.
They are fourth and inches, and the center turning around and telling Jim Harbaugh. John Vitale told him they had a new nose man.
Goal line defense.
They pound with Perelman for the first down. He's inside the 25-yard line here in the third quarter. Ohio State leading Michigan 14-6. Both Buckeye touchdowns were scored in the opening quarter. Word from the bench is that Mike Sullivan was also shaken up for the Buckeyes. Fred Ritter will not return for the game. Sullivan is out, and so Pat Thomas must step in. This is the 11th play in this drive to start the second half. Harbaugh barking at McMurtry. Morris. And with that effort, he gets to the 22-yard line.
That time, Bob Perelman, the fullback, did not make the block. The defender came off of Perelman's block and made the play.
Clock running with the ball at the 22-yard line. This will be a second down and 8 for Harbaugh and the Wolverines. Harbaugh juggled, caught by Perelman. Inside the 10-yard line. He stayed with it after juggling the ball, and Greg Rogan wrestled him out of bounds, about a 15-yard gain.
There was a break that time for the Wolverines. You'll see Perelman come out of the backfield as if he's going to block to the right. Then he slips underneath Jamie Morris right there, that little X pattern. There he is, bobbles the ball. He's not their best receiver, but he certainly hung on to that one.
Michigan starting to exert itself here.
This is where it gets tough against the Buckeyes.
First and goal. Wiltshire to the 5-yard line, and he's bent backwards. His leg appeared to be wrapped and sent back, and you hate to see a running back when he's wrapped up in that manner.
Get in those awkward positions and get your legs tangled up. Bradley's all right. Came out of that pile.
He's limping a bit as he comes back to the huddle. They have left him in there for second and goal. The Wolverine offensive line brings the team up. On the option, he pitches to Morris. Touchdown, Wolverines! Michigan draws to within 1 point. On the extra point, Michigan will set its line to the left of the ball. That makes the center eligible if they want to go ahead with the swinging gate. They frequently will shift back if they want to kick the extra point. The Buckeyes are attuned to the maneuver. They hold their position. Now remember, Michigan must win this game to get to the Rose Bowl. A tie does not do any good. I think I was premature. I said it was 14-13. That's what it is now, but I knew Gillette would kick that. Now, those of you who are wondering, why did he go for the two and the tie? He must win this game.
Here's a perfectly executed option as Harbaugh comes down the line, deals it off, but Jamie Morris makes a great move on Sonny Gordon right there, turns inside of him, and scores the touchdown. Only the second touchdown in 6 home games have been scored against the Buckeyes.
And the first by a Big Ten team. He's 5'7", 179 pounds, a junior at Michigan. But Jamie Morris packs a wallop, and he delivers for Bo Schembechler. It's 14-13. The drama grows. We'll be right back. Walked off to the sideline, and Brent White, number 88, checks in. He's a sophomore from Dayton, Ohio. This is a first and 10. Buckeyes are inside the Michigan 40. On the option, the pitch is to Workman. Can't get the corner turn. Great defensive play by Steve Seibert. Penn State and Pittsburgh. Jim Nantz, what's going on in that one?
Well, Brent, Penn State is starting to pour it on. Here's the touchdown pass. It'll go 82 yards. However, it's from Matt Kisner and not John Schaefer. The starting quarterback for the Nittany Lions, Schaefer, went down on the first possession of the second half. He's on the Nittany Lion bench with his right hand packed in ice, and Penn State leading 27-7. Let's go back to Brent Nera.
All right, Jim, thank you. We hope that young man is all right. What a record he has. A loser in only one football game since Pop Warner. That was to Oklahoma in last year's Orange Bowl. They run the draw with Workman. He breaks a tackle and gets to the 32-yard line. He was wrapped up, and he broke free, and Andre McIntyre finally got him.
He did break free. Didn't have really much of a hole. Looks like he stopped. It's a little misdirection play. You see him all right there making, trying to make the play. Finally, McIntyre and Rivers comes in to make the play. 13:54. Another ground-level look at it. He just squeezes through virtually no hole. This Workman is really a fine running back.
Third and 3. Carsados hums it to Carter for the first down for the 15-yard line. That's the first pass Chris Carter has caught since the opening drive. But it picks up 17 yards.
Just a little look in right there, and he waits for the ball, and then he runs through two tacklers. Hicks, number 17. There's the throw by Carsadas. There's 17, Hicks. And on Carter goes. Just give him the ball, and he takes off with it.
First and 10 for the Buckeyes. They lead Michigan by a point. They're inside the 15. Here's Workman. He battles for a yard. Darlon Rivers coming around to make the stop.
Keep coming back to a little misdirection where Workman steps to the field side and then comes back behind his left guard and left tackle pulling. But both times that they have run it, and this has been on this drive, Michigan has shut it down.
Hutchison brings in the play from the Buckeye sideline. Second down and 9. Harrison Carter of the wide men. Carsados wants Carter. Incomplete.
Whoa, what a job, Carter. Carter was delayed along the line. Carsados wanted to throw it sooner. You see it right at the top. You see him right here. He is. He starts to go up right here, and he's delayed, and then he breaks in behind him. Watch. Carsados fakes to the fullback, but he's held up right there along the line. Now he goes out of bounds. He's forced out of bounds. A good job.
Darlon Rivers was working on him on that side, and he did a superb job defensively. This is 3rd and 9. Carsados to Workman. He's to the 10-yard line. And Brent White brings him down for the Wolverines.
Good response by Michigan after the ball was thrown and completed. A screen pass, and the secondary responded well to it.
It will be a field goal opportunity for the Buckeyes at the 5:40 mark. Ohio State leading by 1. Now here is France, who missed a 43-yarder, and this is a 27. And France is 1 of 2. An important field goal for the Buckeyes. They've gone up by 4 points. We'll be right back at 17-13 Ohio State with the Rose Bowl and the Cotton Bowl on the line here this afternoon in Columbus, Ohio, along with Ara Parsegan. I'm Brent Musburger. Pat Amaro puts the ball on the tee for Earl Bruce. The Buckeyes lead Michigan 17-13. They have led all the way. The Wolverines close to within a point, and then the Buckeyes march down and kick the field goal. There are 5 minutes and 26 seconds to play in the third quarter. Low kickoff. Morris at the 3. Ran into his own man, and that helped jam him up there at the 24-yard line. We had a great confrontation between Darlon Rivers and Chris Carter.
There they are, Rivers, the defender, and of course Carter. Now he will hold him and force him out of bounds here. The fact that he forced him out, that means Carter can come back in and be an eligible receiver. But if he had gone on his own, he's no longer eligible. But watch Rivers funnel him to the outside. Carsados wants to throw it, waits. Then Carter finally turns inside. Rivers reaches in there with his left arm, does a magnificent defensive job.
Harbaugh and the Wolverines with a first down. Morris straight through the middle. Jamie Morris free at midfield. Out of bounds at the 24-yard line. William White and Sonny Gordon chasing Morris down. It's a 52-yard gain. The biggest play of the afternoon by the Wolverines.
What a job this was. Here comes Perriman through, leading the play. You see Jamie pop through the hole. There's Perriman, throws the block on Sonny Gordon, 7. 29, Rogan trying to catch him. Finally run out of bounds by Sonny Gordon.
Chris Spielman, the All-American linebacker, took the fake and moved in the wrong direction and was quickly sealed off by Michael Dames, number 76. Dames would not let Spielman back into the action. It's 1st and 10 at the 24. And Perriman gains a yard, no more. Michael Key, 30, there to hit him. It'll be second and nine for Harbaugh and the Wolverines.
Boy, that was sudden. The Buckeyes have not been giving the big plays. They get up a lot of yardage and a lot of first downs, but they don't give the big play up. That time, Jamie popped through, and now they're in great field position.
Here is second and nine. Wolverines trailing Ohio State 17-13. Harbaugh will run. Now he shovels it off. Beautiful job to Perriman, who was working back in front of him, and he's inside the 10-yard line. A 15-yard gain. It's 17-13. Michigan trailing, but on the move. They have a first and goal from the 8. Morris hammers to the 1 and in for the touchdown. Touchdown, Michigan. He would not be denied. Beckler signaling back to the team that he will go for two. He does not want to sit on three with a tie sending Ohio State to the Rose Bowl. He would prefer to be only up by two. He must take this gamble right here because of the point spread right now. It's 19-17, and they will come up and go for two. Throw incomplete, and a field goal would put him ahead as Jim Beckler is complaining that a receiver was pushed. That's why they give Jim Beckler an extension award.
He's hot. Let's take a look at the touchdown. Were they just nothing but a power off tackle with the lead back? These two men right here lead this play. Good blocking. There's the hole. Jamie finds it, pops through there. Now watch him give that second effort and get that ball into the end zone right there.
Jim Beckler being escorted back off the field. And let's take a look at that conversion and see if we can pick up any holding, which is what Mo is complaining about.
Let's see who he was complaining about in here.
Harbaugh was back. He had plenty of time, and you can
see. Oh, right there. Absolutely.
The receiver was smacked at the 2-yard line.
Yes, absolutely. It was a definite interference. He's got every reason to call that play or complain about that play. And could be very important in the outcome of the game.
It's a 2-point Michigan lead, and Era used the telestrator to show folks what to look at.
Right here, you'll see the defender come in and hit him way before the ball gets there. Here it comes. Right there. Look at that contact right there.
And Harbaugh is aiming.
Right here is the contact. Harbaugh now trying to throw the ball. Now that's pass interference.
No doubt about it. They have kicked a big one down there on a 2-point play. And Schimbeckler was justified in his angry response.
He certainly was.
But nevertheless, he has moved into the lead at the 3:53 mark here of the third. In four plays, they go 76 yards in 1:33, and Jamie Morris was the star. Two carries for 60 yards in that drive. Everett Ross awaits the kickoff. Ball is short again, and Holland is at the 10. Holland down at the 27-yard line.
Another look at the touchdown from ground level view. This is nothing but power and determination on the part of Jamie Morris. Right there, you just see he's tackled. It looks like he's short, but three Buckeyes can't keep him out of there, and he crosses the goal line and puts the ball down for the touchdown.
This was the play that set up the touchdown. Jamie Morris, 52 yards.
Then he also carried it in, and especially on that touchdown run, he showed great determination. He was stopped at the 2-yard line and came free. Now it's up to Jim Carsados and the Buckeyes. They trail it by 2 points. And Schimmeckler is still upset. He is raging on the far sideline. There is a penalty flag down at the 45.
Better quiet down.
Schimmeckler having to be restrained by his staff.
March off 15. It's tough enough to stop the Buckeyes. They're going to add, going to reduce the distance to the goal line by 15 yards. See, this is the problem. Brent, he's justified in his complaint. There's nothing you can do about it at this stage, and he still hasn't calmed down yet.
Yeah, this is like a basketball coach going too far and getting a technical foul. Well, there's no question he's right about this, Eric. Show everybody again.
Exactly. You'll see that right here, the end comes off. Slow blocks. Harbaugh's getting ready to throw the ball. There's the contact right there, and he has every justification to complain.
But he has registered the complaint, and now it's time to go back to work. You're still ahead by 2 points. It's not going to be changed. They hand it off to Workman. He can't battle free behind the right side, and Andy Moeller wraps him up there. Strong defensive effort by their captain and field general, Andy Moeller. This makes it second and 10.
Well, Ohio State is a very dangerous team when you got guys like Chris Carter around, Nate Harris, and their backup people, and Jamie Holland and Everett Ross. They can score at any time and get the big play anytime. And here they come with the three receivers, wide receivers.
Carsados calling the play at the line. Workman, he's wrapped up. Great play by Mark Mesner, number 60. And this is the most enthusiasm we have seen from this defensive bunch all day.
Right there in the first quarter, they seemed a little bit flat. Watch, Mesner does not buy the fake. He goes right after Workman and makes the play.
Mesner bringing him down, and unfortunately for the Buckeyes, Workman was shaken up. He is down at the 42. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. 1917 Michigan. First and 10 for Harbaugh. He continues to bark out signals at the line of scrimmage. Morris will not get free. Great defensive play by Greg Logan, the cornerback who came up and applied pressure.
That's the kind of secondary support you need on that play that they've run to the weak side with Jamie Morris. Either inside or outside, he reads it, but that time Logan fought off his blocker and came up and did a nice job.
Coach, is it possible that the plays are being preset and Schimmeckler has instructed Harbaugh every time to bark like that at the line of scrimmage? I can't remember a play in the second half. Now let's see what Harbaugh does here.
I'll explain to you right after the display here. There it is again. You see, he has a call of either or. He always calls an audible. It's either one player or the other, and then he selects it.
Sideline, Higgins, caught at the 35-yard line. A big first down for the Wolverines.
What Brent Musper, Bo Schimmeckler sets in is either a running play or two running plays, right or left, or a pass. Now, this one was either a run or a pass, and he hits it up the sideline, but it looks like we're going to have a penalty on this play. There it is by Harbaugh, right on the sidelines to Higgins. Let's see what the penalty is.
Whatever it is, Schimmeckler is not happy.
The receiver went out of bounds on his own, was the first to touch the...
Okay, see?
That's what you explained earlier in the game on Chris Carter.
Yes, exactly. If you go out on your own, then you cannot return as an eligible receiver. However, if you are forced out by a defender, then you are ineligible to return.
Now, Jim Harbaugh
is going over to the sideline as the officials come over to Earl Bruce. Harbaugh will immediately go over to the Michigan coaching staff. Bruce is having the play explained to him. We have 1:13 left in the third quarter here in the battle for supremacy in the Big Ten. And it's just your typical neighborhood war between these two schools.
Just another Ohio State-Michigan game. 2 points separates these two teams, and we still have over 16 minutes to go.
We've had big plays, big mistakes. We've had controversy. We've had a little bit of everything. We've also had a whale of a football game. It's 19-17. Michigan with the ball, a first and 10. Ball is on the Michigan 35. There was movement. Tight end Brown came across. He jumped on the wrong count. And so the penalty goes against the Wolverines of Schembechler.
Bo's system has always been to call two situations, sometimes three. Here's
by the offense.
And of course, Harbaugh has to come up each time and make that call. Under normal circumstances where the crowd's not into it, it isn't necessary for him to cup his hands. He makes his call at the line and everybody hears him. Now, to ensure that everyone is getting the signal and getting the call, he's cupping his hands and shouting to both sides, and it taking an additional time to do so.
Yardage is stepped off against the Wolverines, and Jim Harbaugh will come to the line of scrimmage. And one of the first men he will look at is number 36, Chris Spielman. They run Morris on the draw into the hole and out to the 38-yard line. Michael Key, number 30, brings him down for the Buckeyes.
Little sprint draw. They double up on the nose man. Right there is the double, but Jamie comes clear against the grain and picks up about 8 yards on the play. Well, more than that, nine, I guess.
How important is Ohio State, Michigan? At the half, they told us Fred Ritter would not return. Do you know who's playing the nose for the Buckeyes? Fred Ritter. It's second down and six. There's a penalty flag. There was movement again in that offensive line on the right side with a couple ticks of the clock left, and Jamie Morris is holding his left. Morris was down. Now he's back up. He's okay.
It's unusual for Michigan. Normally they do not make mistakes. They've made two in the last three plays.
Now, how much would the signal calling at the line of scrimmage be responsible for what the offensive line is doing?
Well, it shouldn't be a problem because they do it. Wait, let's listen to the call.
We're back in motion, and we have the tackle moving on the offense.
That's a little bit of everything.
But it shouldn't be a problem. I don't know why it's occurring now, because they call her plays the same way all the time. But they have had two mistakes, which is unusual for Michigan teams. They very seldom make errors.
To get a first down here, they must get the ball out to the Michigan 46-yard line. That's where they have to go. The line of scrimmage here is the 39. And that signals the end of the third quarter. Michigan has taken the lead, and we'll be right back after this message and a word from your local stations. And it's either California, here we come, or the eyes of Texas are smiling on you. Harbaugh drops it off to Perriman. Perriman free at midfield for Michigan. Inside the 40-yard line before Sonny Gordon. The Rover saves six. A 23-yard Harbaugh to Perriman reception.
Beautifully set up screen. Harbaugh came back into the pocket, was patient with it, looked it off. Then he drops the ball off to Perriman. The wall sets up. There's a great seam that opens up right there. And he runs right into his own man, McMurtry, right there.
Perriman has caught three passes for 53 yards this afternoon. Harbaugh and the Wolverines with a first down at the Buckeye 38. 19-17. Michigan leading by two and on the move. Morris getting to the corner. Inside the 20, and oh, how hard he runs.
Boy, did he read that beautifully. That was designed to go off tackle. And he saw it was clogged, dipped it to the outside, picked up a great block from his fullback, and raced for a first down. He's not disappointed. Watch here. As you see, the Jamie goes to the off-tackle spot. Now watch the fullback, Perriman, right there, throw the block that sets Jamie to the outside.
Jamie Morris, 22 carries for 172 yards and two touchdowns. It's Perriman. He busts inside the 15-yard line on this drive. This game changed completely in Shin Beckler's favor, and it started back in the second quarter.
Exactly. The tide changed. The momentum changed. After a dramatic first quarter for the Buckeyes, they've been throttled, and Michigan has moved the football effectively both on the ground and in the air, and the statistics already for Michigan are 461 yards. But they're only 2 points ahead in the most important statistic, and that's the score.
Higgins is the lone wide receiver. Morris. And he's down to the 7-yard line before Pat Thomas can tackle him. Jimmy Harbaugh keeping it moving. And Wiltshire getting the play from Shin Beckler's staff. He'll bring it onto the field. Michigan with a first and goal at the 7. Wiltshire, touchdown Wolverines. Scores, and from the swinging gate, Michigan sets up for the extra point with Mike Gillette. He is just perfect this afternoon. It's 26-17.
Watch the right guard, Mark Hammerstein, pull through. And look at this, just power football. Hammerstein gets a great block, number 78, as he leads it right up through the hole. And Wiltshire really thrust in there.
All afternoon, it has been the two offensive lines. First, it was the Buckeyes. Now it's Huzar, Dame, Vitale, Hammerstein, and Elliott pounding on that road to the Rose Bowl. We'll be right back. Trying to up that statistic to number 32. They have a 9-point lead with 12:46 to go here in Columbus, Ohio. That scoring drive, 9 plays, 86 yards, 419, and Wiltshire took it the final 7 yards. Moons with the ball on the tee at the 35. Holland bringing it out to the 25-yard line before White tackles him there.
Mark Hammerstein right here pulls, 284 pounds, great blocking on the inside, but watch Mark, number 78. He blocks David Brown, who is only 180 pounds. What a mismatch right there. And there goes Wiltshire with determination and effort in the end zone.
Hammerstein also led Morris into the end zone on an earlier touchdown. He has had a big afternoon blocking for Michigan. Now it's first and 10. The big play man Chris Carter is slotted to the left for the Buckeyes. Three wide receivers. Carsonis to throw on first down. Intercepted. McIntyre. He's back to the 35-yard line. He forced one toward Carter. Carsonis took a tremendous shot as the ball was being released, and he forced the ball toward Chris Carter. Andre McIntyre with coverage all the way.
Here we see it. Carsonis really gets hit on this play, but he tries to hit the crossing receiver Carter right there. And watch McIntyre step right in and make the interception, and of course Carter gets him down.
And as Jim Carsonis releases the ball, you'll see the shot he takes. Billy Harris, the nose man, falls at his knee and inadvertently crumples him right there. Michigan has scored each time they've handled the ball here in the second half. Three possessions, three touchdowns. Morris to the 34-yard line.
The Buckeyes need to tighten up that defense and get the ball back.
Now, Aaron, you said that the Michigan coaching staff made some of the best adjustments in the Big Ten at the half. What were some of those adjustments that have opened it up here? They've dominated the second half.
Well, I think there was a momentum shift, Brent, in that second period that really helped them for one thing. And then also, in the blocking combination, they felt that they could go ahead and run with the blocking patterns that they had, only they're doing it with greater execution right now, and it seems as if the Buckeyes have worn down some. Now they've come to a goal line defense.
Harbaugh wants his tight end, overthrew him, incomplete.
Big risk for the Buckeyes. They felt that they needed to do that. They came into a foot situation, man-to-man, but Harbaugh just overthrew his receiver.
26-17, 11:44 on the clock. We're in Ohio Stadium in Columbus, Ohio, and along with Ara Parsegan, I'm Brent Musburger. The Buckeyes scored touchdowns the first two times they handled the ball. Now they have been unable to score except for a field goal since then. And Michigan has seized control in its drive toward the Rose Bowl. Jim Harbaugh guaranteed a victory. He's making good on that promise right now.
It's a big play for the Buckeyes. They need to shut down Michigan, get the ball back.
And Jamie Morris wanted a timeout. He could see the clock running down. Morris is hot. Morris is upset. He was signaling timeout at the tailback spot.
He was wrong on it. He never should have done that. You allow the quarterback Harbaugh to look back to the referee. And he put his hands up and started to call timeout. The official gave it to him. It's a charge timeout.
Well, let's see how the Ivy League championship is unfolding. Jim Nance?
Well, Brett Cornell is coming back here. Marty Stallone hones in on Chris Hahn. The 11-yard score moves the Big Red within three with 11 minutes to go. Let's go back to Brent and Ara.
Good duel there for supremacy in the Ivy League. And here it's 26-17, Jim. Harbaugh is 7 of 9 for 112 yards in this half. Good protection. Drops it off to Brown. Brown is belted at the 31 by Key. And what a game that linebacker has played for Earl Bruce. Down to Pat O'Brien. Pat?
All right, Brett. Tom Tupa is throwing the ball here. Carsonis was hit on his left ankle. He is favoring the ankle as I watch him walk around here. But they expect him to be back in. It's a bruised left ankle. Let's go back upstairs.
And Mike Gillette comes in to attempt the field goal. It'll be a 47-yard attempt.
He's got the kind of leg.
Blocked. And Monty Robbins dives on it there at the 45. That was a great move by the punter, who is also the holder. The Buckeyes might have gone a long way if they picked up that blocked field goal.
That's a good point, Brent, because it's an advanceable ball. 95, Darrell Lee right there, puts up his left arm right there. He gets the seam and he blocks it.
With 11 minutes to go, Ohio State gets a fresh breath. We'll be right back. Darrell Lee, with that blocked field goal attempt, gives the ball back to the Buckeyes. Jim Karsatos, tender ankle and all, back at quarterback. He'll throw on first down. Wants Nate Harris. And he is smacked by Garland Rivers after a gain of 20 yards. Let's go back to that blocked field goal, Errol.
Michael Dames is a left guard. He's right up here. Darrell Lee is here. Now watch as he penetrates on the inside of Michael Dames. Takes the inside seam right here, gets his left arm up and blocks it. And Monty Robbins does a marvelous job of smothering the ball. There's the block with his left arm. Robbins, because this is an advanceable ball.
Karsatos runs the sprint draw, and it's Workman turning the corner brilliantly at the 26-yard line. Chris Carter was in front of him blocking.
That field position change was really a big one. That block was really a big one. And now the Buckeyes are on the move. Here's Workman with that little draw play coming in behind Cooper, who blocks Moeller, number 49. And he breaks it to the outside of Garland Rivers. And he's finally knocked out of bounds after a good game by Gant.
A 14-yard gain for the first down to the 22. Three wide receivers for the Buckeyes. Ross, Carter, and Harris. Karsatos with a brilliant fake to Cooper, keeps it and gets to the 17, where Andre McIntyre wraps him up.
Running the option play weak, apparently that ankle injury or knee injury, which we thought it was when he got sacked back there or hit right after the pass was intercepted, has recovered pretty well.
This will be second and four for Ohio State. They trail Michigan by 9 points, 26-17. 10 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. Karsatos rolling to the right. Throws to Carter, who dives. Touchdown, Ohio State.
What a...
giving chase.
That time they kept leverage on him, ran him out of bounds, which also stops the clock.
Spielman taking the defensive call from the Ohio State sideline. Harbaugh gets the play delivered to his huddle.
See what Bo's got on.
Harbaugh will throw. Penalty marker is down, incomplete. Lennelly-Barker was thrown behind the blocking pocket by Quinn. He might have had holding.
Holding on the offense.
In the second half, the Wolverines seized control. Morris banged in from 4 yards out. The Wolverines pulled to within a point, 14-13. Then France kicked a 27-yard field goal, 17-13 Buckeyes. Morris scored his second touchdown, and it was 19-17 Michigan. And the Wolverines got one out of Wiltshire. The score went to 26-17. And then the Buckeyes rallied on a 17-yard pass to Carter. Morris has scored twice for the Wolverines. Carter scoring two so far for the Buckeyes. The penalty declined, giving Michigan a 3rd and 9. The Buckeyes think they can stop them here and force a punt. It's Morris. And Morris, the unstoppable one, gets the first down beyond midfield. And Jamie Morris, who has been the main man all afternoon, squeezes 10 more yards out.
Look at the draw play. Jamie comes up. Look at the hole. There goes Perriman leading through, blocking on Leach, number 8. Finally brought down by Derek Eisenman, number 10, but not before he gets the first down.
Having one of the greatest afternoons ever for a running back in a Michigan-Ohio State game. Jamie Morris, 28 carries, 205 yards, and 2 touchdowns, and he gets a well-deserved rest. Thomas Wiltshire replaces him. Perriman. He pounds inside the 45-yard line into the arms of Spielman. The clock moving at the 4:40 mark. Michigan leading by 2. And a win here will send them to the Rose Bowl. Buckeyes must have the ball back. It's 4:15. This is 2nd and 3. Behind Perriman, short of that first down, hammered. Spielman and Leach delivered the blow for the Buckeyes.
Leach put a good hit on him there. You can see the obvious concern there of Earl Bruce. Needs the ball back.
So Penn State stays unbeaten. Here it's 26-24, Michigan. And the time remaining now down to 3:30. The Wolverines keeping the clock moving. The Buckeyes must have it back. It's Wiltshire battling for another. And he fumbled. Ohio State has it. The Buckeyes get the break they've been looking for.
There's a nice opening there. He gets good blocking. Let's see. Oh, that was close to being down, I guess.
David Brown delivering the blow and forcing the fumble with Sonny Gordon pouncing on the ball. We have 3:17 to go. Buckeyes ball. It may come down to Matt France attempting a field goal. Here is a young man who a year ago in high school attempted only one field goal and kicked only one extra point. That's because his high school's offense down in Cincinnati didn't give him any more opportunities. But during the season, he moved to number 1. And now he could wind up with the biggest opportunity of the season for the Buckeyes. 3:17 to go. After the fumble, Jim Carsalos with a chance. Great protection. Throws over the middle to Harris. Incomplete. Garland Rivers back defensively.
He was open, Brent, but there was good ball response by the entire Michigan secondary, and looks like Nate Harris is down. Here's another look at it. You'll see the Carsanos puts the ball in there well. Here he comes, number 26, Nate Harris, right down the middle. The ball's right there, but just as he gets the ball, enough contact is made there that he drops it.
We're going to break because of the injury to Harris, and we'll be right back. Harris walked off the field. It's Carter, Ross, and Holland. Penalty markers thrown because of the action. Carsanos thinks he's got a free shot, and he goes long toward Carter, and Carter was being double-teamed. Tony Gant, 14, was there. Flags thrown because of that movement at the scrimmage line.
So it looked like offside by Michigan, it appeared.
Quinn receiving the information regarding France and his field goal status against Schembechler and Michigan. They must pick up 36 yards for a 43-yard attempt. And 43 is the longest attempt France has had.
Okay. We have defense. Offside.
Now, as we cut to Schembechler, who had turned away from Quinn, he doesn't realize that Quinn also called a foul against the offense. He's got offsetting penalties, and I don't think Bo even knew it.
Penalties offset.
Mark Messner, number 60, jumps offside there.
But they also had a penalty against Ohio State.
Okay. We have
illegal motion. Offside.
Okay.
Play the down over. Offsetting penalties.
It's been a long, tough afternoon for him.
Had to sort that out.
So that makes it second and 10. The ball is at the Ohio State 37-yard line. Carsanos has Carter, Ross to his right. The blitz. Under pressure, he drops the screen off to Cooper. The fullback screen. And Cooper to the 49-yard line.
First down.
A first down for the Buckeyes.
Well executed by Carsanos. He made a full spin in the turn. Cooper got lost in the action here. Watch Carsanos here. He gets pressure right there. Messner's right on him. Now he turns and dumps the ball off to Cooper. And Cooper does a nice job of running the ball upfield. Mallory, number 8, is blocked. Eric Campbell brings him down, number 5, at 171 pounds.
We have 2:48 to play. Carsanos, with good protection, throws it underneath to Carter. And Carter hammered out of bounds at the Michigan 43 by Rivers.
Boy, he's dangerous, isn't he? Seems sneak underneath in front of the linebackers right there in the seam. Now he shakes a tackle right there. And finally run out of bounds by Garland Rivers, number 13.
We have 2:41 to play. The Buckeyes trail it by 2. This is second and 3 for Carsanos. Holland is his wide receiver to the left. Workman straight ahead for the first down, and a penalty marker is thrown into the pile.
Looked like the mask. Had his hand on the mask. Shot I had at it. See, he's kind of has his hand on. Let's see if he turns his head. Well, he had his hand on the mask. 5 yards. Down to the 36, Brent.
It's a first and 10 against Schembechler and the Wolverines. The clock down to 2:34.
Ross and Carter are to Carsato's left. Good protection. Throws deep toward Carter. Knocked down in the end zone. And that was Ivan Hicks.
Boy, Ivan Hicks did a great job. Looked like Carter was open. They're zoning off. You watch him come down. Now Ivan Hicks will come in, but he'll be trailing Carter. And he reaches in with his left arm. There's Hicks right there. Ball in the air. Looks like Carter's open. He can jump. Bang. If the ball had been higher, Carter had gone up and gotten it for a touchdown.
2:14. Second and 10. Pat Amaro warming up along with France. Holland and Carter are to Carsato's left. The draw. Workman slips. Gets to the 35, and Andre McIntyre helped him slip.
Okay, third and...
It's third and 10, and the warm-ups continue on the sideline. They are keeping the clock moving.
1:40.
Quick throw to Carter. Carter is short of the first down. This will be a big decision for the Buckeye coaching staff. This will be a fourth down. The ball will be spotted at the 29-yard line, just inside it on the far hash mark.
Got Eric Campbell giving him a lot of cushion. There's Carter.
Now, Ohio State has used its second timeout. Remember, they were penalized for the first one. They have only one left, and a huge decision by both coaching staffs coming up.
Welcome to...
Matt France will attempt what would be a 45-yard field goal, if successful, into a slight breeze. That hit on the far sideline left Ohio State with a fourth and 2. And rather than gamble at 106, they will let France try his longest field goal of the season. Era, how about the strategy on the Ohio State part?
I think it's the right thing. He's got fourth down about, well, it's 2.5, 3 yards. He fails. He never has the opportunity to win the ball game. And here he is. He's got to kick over a 45-yard field goal into the wind, as you pointed out.
On its way, no good. Off to the side. There is still 1 minute to play. I can't believe that the Wolverines are celebrating right now. It has happened before. Mike Lantry. It was 1973 for Michigan, and he was unable to kick a field goal, and that game stayed tied. He missed again the following year, and they were beaten.
Oh, that's tough on him. Boy, you got a feel for him.
One timeout is all that remains here for Ohio State. Jim Harbaugh kneels down to kill it, and it will be second down at about 11. And now the celebration can begin back in Detroit. Because California, here come the Wolverines.
Dallas. The last time out, as you pointed out, and they can't do anything about it, and all Harbaugh's going to do is kill the clock. But what a ball game this has been.
It has featured a little bit of everything. And the Buckeyes had a chance. But Matt Francis, 45-yard field goal, off to the side. And the Wolverines, with a dramatic comeback here. Down. He won't even risk handing the ball off. They don't want to fumble in this situation. The clock continues to run, and all the Buckeyes can do now is watch it come down. And I'll bet the hooping and hollering is underway in Ann Arbor and throughout the state of Michigan, where they love this football team. That's going to do it. It was a great game, but Bo Schembechler gets the victory ride.
And it is a sweet ride indeed for Schembechler, getting carried off the field, not only because of this win.